All right, my friends, this is going to be part two on my propeller video. What I have here is a nail. I don't know how many pennies it is. Standard lumber nail. 10 penny, I guess. Got two drill bits. A little small one to use for a pilot hole, and one just a little bit bigger than a nail. And the only way I know it's bigger than a nail, I stuck the nail down in the hole of the drill bit holder, and it fits in there. Now, I'm thinking there might be an air pocket in this double bottom I got in here, because I didn't put my holes in there. So we'll see if it still stays snapped up after we drill the holes. And then we'll see about soldering it together. I'm going to try to hold it on the center. Although I wouldn't bet on it staying there. I don't have a center punch punched into it. Oops, slipped off. Didn't really drill, it kind of melted its way through there. Now there won't be an air pocket in there now. Let's see how it snaps together. Oh, it's pretty snug. It doesn't really matter if it's not perfectly straight or not. The wind's still going to turn it. We haven't welded together. There we go. Let's finish drilling our hole. Got my pilot hole in there. Now let's make the nail hole. Pretty smooth. Let's do this one. I think we'd be better off with a hot nail than we would drill. It's loose. Okay, you definitely got to put it together before you put the nail in there. But we do have the holes drilled. Gonna spin pretty good. Now let's see if we can get her welded together. All right, I'm gonna heat my soldering gun up till it gets nice and warm. straight. I got this hub on there, but I definitely got it squeezed together fairly straight. First, we're going to just melt in a couple of places to try to stick it together. Melting at it till I feel like it's stuck to the inner piece of plastic. Not stuck, melted together, I should say. Several places. What's the worst that could happen? It could come apart. I don't think it will, though. I think I'm going to look into buying me a plastic welding kit. They make them. You could actually feed some plastic into there, just like welding. Now you could do the same thing if you had a nail, held it with a pair of pliers, you wouldn't want to burn yourself. Heat it on a gas stove and just kind of touch it. I guarantee you that'll melt that plastic. Looks like I got quite a few welded places on there. Guess if I do too many, I'll cut it right in half. It squeezes like it's solid. Where's my nail? Now if my nail hole is too snug, I can run a drill through bit through there and make it bigger, but it feels like it's going to be all right. It's pretty good. Now we got to come up with something to mount it on. Okay, we need a board or a stick. Now, either in the rest of part two or part three, we'll paint this booger with it. With alcohol ink. Somebody pointed out to me, and they're probably quite accurate, that the chemicals in regular paint would probably melt this plastic. We don't want that, but I guarantee you alcohol ink will color it. Now you wouldn't have to use a nail. You could use a big heavy-duty pin or something, but you want something that's going to last a while. We need a board or stick. Let's see, this piece of wood would do all right, but it's just a piece of molding. I think this piece of molding would break. All right, I need a drill bit just a little smaller than the nail this time. Let's go with this one. This looks like a piece of poplar. It was a piece of molding on a dresser at one time. Nail's definitely going to be too long. We need to shorten it. Yep. In fact, that nail might split that piece of wood. We'll find out here momentarily. We definitely need to shorten the nail. Wouldn't want it sticking out in the back and hurt somebody. Let's cut it right about there. Well, it's not the greatest job in the world, but it's on there. Let's go see if we can't complete this pinwheel. In this video, I'm going to use some alcohol, isopropyl alcohol. I don't know if it'll clean off the magic marker or not. We're fixing to find out. Oh yeah, it takes it right off. The lines where I draw it on there to cut it is what I'm washing off. You could leave them, but you're going to be able to see them through the alcohol ink. I'm not going to worry about that glue on there. I wanted to make it pretty. I could spend a lot of time on this. This is just a how-to video. Okay, we got most of it off. There's a little bit right there. Alright, let's go for some green. We need a paintbrush. Where did I put the paintbrushes? Alright, let's go with... I don't know, any of them would probably work. We'll try this one. I should have painted it before I put it on the board.